Hello, and welcome to this quick video. I'm Rick Vanover with Veeam, and I want to talk to you today about the backup copy job. Now, the backup copy job is really central to something that we've talked about here at Veeam, the 3-2-1 rule. Three different copies of data, two different media, one of them offsite. The backup copy job is really one of the easiest ways to do that. And you can do that really easily with the backups that you have under management by Veeam. So let's jump into the lab and set one up for you. So I'm looking at the Veeam Backup and Replication console, and I have a number of things going on. But I want to draw your attention to this one backup job that I have here for what I'm calling cyber recovery assets. There's six virtual machines in there. It's built on a tag, but let's make a backup copy job. So before I go any further, I should highlight that a backup copy job doesn't copy the files. So if I look over here in the target column, you'll see that these backups go into my Veeam hardened repository. It's not just going to pick those files up and copy them elsewhere. Let me explain what happens. So you go up here and you would select a backup copy job. And by the way, you can do that for the image level backups, virtual machines, Windows, Linux, Mac, and you also can do it with the application level backups that are taken as well. So let's do a backup copy job. And the first question we're going to have is, what are we going to call it? So let's just call it backup copy job cyber recovery assets. So for a consistency standpoint, I know that my backup is done and then a backup copy job as well. And one of the first questions you're going to be asked is, do you want it to be immediate mode or periodic mode? Now, I recommend the default here because the mirroring of these restore points will initiate the backup copy job as soon as the restore points are created. This is also an important time to remind you, it's not just copying the files. What a backup copy job does is it actually says it right here. It creates local and remote copies of your backups by reading those restore points. So basically the source is an existing backup job, and the target is a backup file, okay? So it's really imperative that we understand that. I highly recommend also that you don't get into the business of manipulating Veeam backup files. You also could go into the pruning mode, the periodic copy, which only takes the latest restore point, especially if you're concerned about network bandwidth. But I'm gonna go with the default, the immediate mode. And I'm gonna be asked, what am I building the backup copy job from? So let's take it from the backup jobs that I have. Number 15, cyber recovery assets, really clean. That's the one I want to use. And the backups on disk are 166 gigabytes. Now, when we think about the 3-2-1 rule, three different copies of data, two different media, one of which is offsite. Move this over here so you can see what I'm talking about. I currently have the backups going to the Veeam hardened repository on Linux. So I already have that first copy on immutable storage, but there's no such thing as too much immutability. So the next question I'm going to ask is, where am I going to put this? So I'm actually going to put this on my scale-out backup repository that I have configured. This is double play immutability, meaning the first copy is object storage on premises, the second copy of the scale-out backup repository. The second copy of the scale-out backup repository goes to object storage in a public cloud provider. Both of those are immutable. So what this will do here, this will actually be officially a triple play immutable. My first backups are on the Veeam hardened repository with immutability. The backup copy job will go to this scale-out backup repository, which uses two different object storage resources, both with immutability. So this is a super resilient technique, and all three storage systems are completely independent copies. I can have 7 days in this backup copy job, and then I can also do some additional retention. So this is really important if you want to have a long tail of retention, like monthly and weekly backups. For example, a weekly backup, I could have 4 weekly backups built on Sunday's backups, and then I could have another, let's just say 12 months built on the first week of the month, right? So you have a lot of control. Now, one thing I'll highlight is that those are, this would be, let's see, 16 independent full backups, okay? Now, I have a storage efficiency in use here, but keep that in mind. If you don't have a storage efficiency in use, that would be, in this example, 16 full backups, because these are individual full backups on disk. So I'll go ahead and set that up. And then I have a warning, which is super important. Like, I am taking my backups from Phoenix to Ohio. So this is a potential data sovereignty violation. Now, if you think about the 3-2-1 rule, I'm intentionally wanting to go off-site. So this is okay for me, but we want to make sure that we get that right before we configure that. And I guess it also makes a big difference if I say yes to that. So I had four, sorry, I had zero, and I had a whole year. Sorry about that. So yes, we'll configure that and we'll get this warning. We'll proceed. I have the option with the backup copy jobs to go directly, okay? So what I mean by direct is that the Veeam services will read from the backup repository and write them to the other backup repositories directly. Now, I have the ability to do global network throttling, but if I wanted to, I can also use Veeam built-in WAN acceleration. Now, this is a purpose-built WAN acceleration. It's not gonna be helpful to help your web traffic cache out better or make other services improve. This is specifically for like Veeam replicas, Veeam backup copy jobs. I have the bandwidth here going to the internet, so I'm good with the direct, but I could set up WAN acceleration if I wanted to. And the other thing, considering that I'm sending a lot of data to the cloud, I could potentially block when this happens during the day. For example, I know that my business needs their internet bandwidth, you know, full service maybe in this window, and this is the local time of the Veeam server. I have a lot of flexibility for this, right? If you're precious on network bandwidth, you have a lot of control. So I'll go ahead and set this up, and it's ready to go to make backup copies on these backups that I've made. And I have already a couple already inventoried, and you can see that they exist here, and then they'll exist in here as backup copies. And once they're in there, you can drive recoveries just like you would anything else, and they would be from other disk systems, including additional immutable copies like I've done. So if you've read anything at Veeam, you know that we talk a lot about the 3-2-1 rule. I'll put a link at the top of the video about our latest blog post about the 3-2-1 rule, and one better, the 3-2-1-1-0 rule, which says you should have at least three different copies of your data on two different media, one of which is offsite, one or more that's either offline, air-gapped, or immutable, and then zero surprises with recovery verification. Really easy to do with the backup copy job. So you can download a trial at veeam.com, and you can set up this functionality to see just how easy it is to make backup copies with Veeam.